Hi, Bill Chatt with the CCP Legal Minute for Wednesday, May 13th, 2020. Obviously, we are still in our shutdown, and now Governor Pritzker has put through the phase opening plan, which is addressing both short, mid, and long-term aspects of trying to go back to normal. We'll talk about that a little bit more on our next webinar Friday at 1 p.m. So what I wanted to talk about today was pending legislation that affects associations. We've touched upon it here and there in the webinars we've done so far, but we've kind of pushed it to the side because the legislator has bigger things on its hands right now, most specifically the COVID crisis, and they're not meeting as normal. So in any given time, there is a lot of pending legislation out there. Right now, there's actually a lot of backed up association legislation. And on my screen, I've actually got a PDF with the legislation as I know it, and then the right column, there is a link button that you can hit on, and it'll take you to the legislator site. You'll see who sponsored it, where it is in terms of the proposal passage, which these are all not passed. So I will put this on our CCP Chicago website. You'll be able to download it and then click on the links. If you have any issues, you can always just email me at bchat@ccpchicago.com. But again, go to our website, ccpchicago.com, and right on the front, in the middle, you're going to see a link for webinar archives and things like that. That's where we put all our videos and our webinars. So without further ado, let's get to it. I'm not going to go through all of them. I'm going to go through the ones that I think are more interesting. And you can go through all of them if you want. So I'm going to take three together. I'm going to take HB, which stands for House Bill 4068, 41, 48, and 4284. This all pertains to charging stations for electric vehicles. Electric vehicles are becoming more prominent, and they're going to be more so in the years to come. So now there's some proposed legislation out there to for CECA associations, make it so a homeowner in a CECA, common interest, can go ahead and install the charging station that they need for their car. And then for both condo and CECA, they are proposing in common element areas, the association devote at least 30% of the available parking spots for electric charge vehicles. Probably a lot easier when you're building a development versus ones that are established. It seems like the legislation is a little light on those details, but nonetheless, they're starting to fight around the edges of this issue. So that is something to take a look at. There's also an energy policy statement for CECA. This has to do with solar panels. As the association has the governing rights to tell people what they can do and what they cannot do, including things like their roofs, this is going to kind of give them a little legislation as to what they have to do when someone wants to install solar panels. So next would be HB 4744. This is the repeated violation remedy. This is a CECA proposal. So again, when you are in a common interest association, things like whether or not you might be able to put an above ground pool, a deck, a shed, landscaping, that's governed by sometimes architectural guidelines, but certainly the declaration itself. And the associations themselves normally could send a violation letter, say, fix it, stop it, otherwise we will do that for you. What this proposed legislation says is after four consecutive quarters of notice, so basically a year. This is a little weird because, you know, as written, it could be things like garbage cans. You'd have to give them four consecutive quarters of notice that you need to take your garbage cans in, or someone's parking. That's one we get a lot, where people park in contravention of the rules and the governing documents. So you'd have to give them four quarters of notice. So that one is an interesting one. HB 4745, Condo Act. This, again, if you're a unit owner and let's say a unit above or next to you leaks into your unit and your association is a little bit lax in getting to fixing it and then maybe mold breaks out, you would always have a cause of action for, say, breach of fiduciary duty. You could bring a declaratory judgment action. What this one says is, particularly in the case of mold, you would have a cause of action for the mold, for them not addressing it. And if successful, you get attorney's fees and costs. That's probably the difference. When you sue for breach of fiduciary duty, or if you were to do something like a derivative action, you may not necessarily get fees and costs. This would codify it, which is important because you have to get attorney's fees and costs when you sue, you either need a document like a contract that says the prevailing party gets it, or you need a statute. So this is the statute that would give it to you. Moving on to HB 5105, this would amend the Homeowners Energy Policy Statement Act. What this is, home rule. So the city of Chicago has its own version of condo law. They always had a shorter time for Section 19 requests. They have other things in there. This would limit a home rule for a municipality or city to go back around what the state was going to put into effect for the Energy Policy Act, and would not let them toy with that. So if they put a statewide Energy Policy Act that gets passed, this would limit municipalities and cities from changing it. HB 5210, this is a condo related one, has to do with 22.1. This is interesting. Talk about this a lot because we do a lot of real estate transactions out of our office. The multi-board contract that is widely used in the Chicagoland area, if you're buying a condo or if you're going to buy into a common interest association, one of the contingencies is the right to examine the governing docs, the declaration, the bylaws, the rules and regulations. And upon the examination, a potential buyer can terminate a contract if they don't find them satisfactory. That contingency reads that you have 5 days from when you get the last governing document delivered. Typically, the other contingencies that are in a real estate contract, inspection, attorney review, are 5 days. So everyone in the real estate transaction is of the expectation that 7 to 10 days, depending on the extensions that people ask for, we've got all our contingencies wrapped up. Under 22.1, associations have up to 30 days to get that. So it's kind of incongruent. There's an incongruence between the contingencies in the real estate contract and what the law allows. So this proposal for HB 5210 would shorten the amount that associations would have to get that information to 5 days. So you'd have to really get things going pretty quick. And HomeWise still relies on the association to do certain approval things. So that's not necessarily a be-all, end-all. You still need to move quicker if that gets passed. Senate Bill 2480, so SB is Senate Bill. 2480 would amend the Condo Act, lease filing fee prohibition. Some associations charge a fee for the acceptance and the processing of a lease. This would outlaw the fees that associations charge for that. Moving down to Senate Bill 3284, again, a Condo Act. This is accessible parking space. So handicapped spots, a lot of older associations may not have any at all for people who need handicapped accessible, especially if they have the ramps coming out the sides or the backs. This, again, would apply to new as well as existing. So this would be a bit of a scramble, perhaps, for existing ones, especially if you have limited parking spots. You'd have to have for anyone that needs it an accessible spot. So, depending on what the needs would be, it's going to be kind of hard to figure out how you do that. But again, not passed. It's proposed. Senate Bill 3435, residency requirement. This is interesting because the act now says there shall be but one class of membership in an association. This would allow associations to prohibit board membership for those who are not residents, so the investors would be shut out. Right now, that is not part of the Condo Act, so that's, again, a proposed piece of legislation. Finally, Senate Bill 3731, this has to do with Section 15 Condo Act. You've seen this occur in Chicago. This is in response to a lot of these associations that were voting to sell themselves. This would increase from 75 to 85% the vote passage to agree to sell the association off to a developer. Again, like I said, this has occurred in the city of Chicago. Seen some declarations themselves, some associations themselves modify, pass amendments to their declarations to codify this 85%. This would make it part of the Illinois Condominium Property Act. So that's kind of just a rundown of the more interesting ones. Again, the entire list that you see in the screen is going to be on our website once this gets posted. If you have any questions, by all means, you can reach out to me at bchat@ccpchicago.com. Or if you didn't get that, you can visit ccpchicago.com, which is our website, and you can click on attorneys. You can find me there. And that's it. So hope to see some of you on Friday at our next webinar. And let's try to stay sane through these crazy times. And we'll see you again shortly.